when it comes to talking about our bodies, there's also like that topic where you don't have to give everybody a hug or a kiss or like, I don't know you. Why am I being forced to hug you? Yeah. Like, I should be able to choose like what my level of comfort is when it comes to like you coming into my personal space.
Yeah. I think that's so important. Like, that's something that I'm thankful that my parents were all about, because like, I'm Haitian. So in our culture, when you greet someone, especially an elder, you kiss them on the cheek. They did not make me feel like I needed to kiss everyone on the cheek. They were just like, you use your, you know, and trust your discernment, which I'm appreciative of that. So now with my daughter, like even with me, I ask her like, can I give you a kiss or can I give you a hug? And sometimes she'll say no, and that's fine. I'm not gonna be like, oh, well, you're hurting mommy's feelings. Like, that's my business, right? Like, do you wanna do a high five? And sometimes she wants to do a high five, and that's fine. Sometimes nothing at all. But I think that like from a younger age, that like that reinforcement is important, because I think a lot of times the messaging is like, well, if you're not gonna hug someone or give them a kiss on the cheek or whatever, like you're not being friendly. That's not polite, right? And I think that, you know, that narrative of being the nice girl, the polite girl, the friendly girl, mm-hmm. doesn't allow space for us to just like claim agency over our bodies. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I agree. I think being the nice girl and the polite girl also has to revert back to yourself. You have to be nice and polite to yourself and mm-hmm. understand what your boundaries are, because I know for me, and I know this may sound terrible to say, but that's one thing that I'm grateful for COVID for, is that I don't feel pressured to hug people or kiss them when I see them, because mm-hmm. that's something that used to make me a little bit uncomfortable, but
right.
I feel like now I have the ability to say no without being judged for it.
Because it's socially acceptable.
Exactly.
Now. Yeah.
So I feel like we just need to change up the narrative a little bit. We need to be okay with saying like, okay, hi, like mm-hmm. we don't need to be physical.
Right, right.
And I think going back to Olivia and I's shared experience of like being in New York, I think the smile, sweetheart, the way that irks my nerves, because sir, you don't know if I'm having a bad day. Mm-hmm. You don't know.
Right.
What if I'm crying? You don't know.
Right.
Like, right. with the mask, I love it. It's like right. my little security blanket. I'm like, I don't have to smile. If I don't like you, I could grunt at you however way I feel like it. Because no one can tell me, oh, you have to smile, because you can't see it anyway.
Right.
So
right.
why does it matter?
And I think that piece like around like smiling is like about like the male gaze, right? Like
yes.
this idea that we need to operate, you know, for the male gaze, smiling and doing certain things with our bodies mm-hmm. and like what we wear and how we, you know, wear our hair and all of these things. Like, we're not here to be of utility for people, you know, we're mm-hmm. not here for men, you know, we're actually here for ourselves.
Mm-hmm. And I hope the power of the mask and it's like almost masking features, it's like, I hope when we all take it off and someone tells us to smile, we just go no mm-hmm. and go about our day. That is
right.
my hope.
So like taking off the literal mask and
literal
the metaphorical mask. Like just being all right with like, I'm not feeling it or you today.
Exactly.
So
like, oh,
right.
give me 6 feet. Thank you.
Right. I love that.